بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على رسولنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأهل بيته أجمعين Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I would like to welcome to our favorite show, Touching Minds. Viewers, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Today, I have got two wonderful students with me. One is Rayyan. Assalamu alaikum, Rayyan.
Wa alaikum salam.
How are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
Assalamu alaikum, Zainab. How are you today?
Fine.
Alhamdulillah. MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. I'm fine, Zainab. Dear viewers, today, inshallah, we'd like to discuss the important topics today. The topic's name is Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent in this world a lot of prophets and messengers. The first prophet was Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And the last prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam. Basically, Adam alayhi salatu wa sallam does not have any doubt in mom. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent another prophet, Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam. He had mom, but he had no dad. His birth really miraculous birth. Then inshallah, today we are going to talk about Prophet Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, about his birth, about his childhood, about his mission, about his vision, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him, what is the purpose to send Isa alayhi salatu wasalam in this world. First of all, I would like to ask one of my favorite students, Rayyan. Inshallah, today, Rayyan, could you tell us about the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
Around 600 years before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born, Prophet Isa alayhi salam had started to teach the unity of Allah. He came as a guidance who will come again. He came to guide the Bani Israel.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Isa alayhi salam in the tribe of Bani Israel.
Yeah.
MashaAllah, Rayyan. Now, Zainab, can you tell us about the birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
In the Quran, it has said, A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Ya Maryam uknuti li rabbiki wasjudu warka'i ma'ar raki'in. This means that the Quran has discussed very little about all the prophets, but the Quran hasn't mentioned the birth of any prophet except Isa alayhi salam. Isa alayhi salam was born into a noble family. His mother's name was Maryam radiallahu anha. However, Isa alayhi salam was born without a father. One day an angel came to Maryam radiallahu anha and told her she was going to give birth. In Surah Maryam, he has also said, قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامُ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرُ وَلَمْ أَكُوا بَغِيًّا. This means that when Maryam radiallahu anha found out that she was going to give birth, she was shocked because she was unmarried. However, she was advised not to tell anyone. While Maryam radiallahu anha was carrying the baby, she sat down next to the date tree where she was going to give birth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her to shake the date tree so the ripe dates can fall. Once she gave birth to Isa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her to have one of the dates and be glad that she gave birth to Isa alayhi salam.
Excellent, mashallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibra'il alayhi salatu wa salam to Maryam, isn't it?
Yeah.
To inform her she is going to get a baby, isn't it? MashaAllah. Rayyan, can you tell us about after giving the birth, then how Maryam alayhi salatu wa salam returned to whom?
After Isa alayhi salam was born, Maryam radiallahu anha returned to her native land. When the people of her land saw her, they became very angry. did not like her. They said to her, "Oh Maryam, why are you a rebel to society? Your family is such a good family. This is not appropriate for you and your family." Maryam radiallahu anha did not say a word but point at Isa alayhi salam. He replied by saying, "Qala inni abdullahi atani al-kitaba waj'alani nabiyya."
Subhanallah.
Allah says in the Quran in chapter 19, verse 30, that Isa alayhi salam said that he is a prophet of Allah and he has a book. The Quran dedicates a whole surah to Maryam radiallahu anha. This shows the importance of Maryam radiallahu anha.
Excellent, mashallah, Rayyan. Basically, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam does not have any dad. That's why after giving the birth Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, she was really, really shy. Yeah, people will make the bad comment. Yeah, that's why she was scared and shy to return to home. Yes,
yes.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed by the Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, "You don't need to be worried, go home." But the people of this area, they are thinking and they are telling Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, "Oh, your dad was a good person, your mom was a good person, but how come you given the birth Isa without any dad, isn't it?" That's why Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam was so shy.
Yeah.
But the little boy Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, just after born, no one can talk.
Yeah.
Isn't it? No one can understand anything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the ability to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to talk during the time of childhood. That does mean after his birth, he was able to talk. Normally, people can't talk, but Allah has given the ability, isn't it?
Yes.
MashaAllah. Then, Maryam, can you tell us what does Isa alayhi salatu wasalam says? What was his speech? He said, Inni Abdullah and Atani al-Kitaba wa ja'alani Nabiya. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Oh, I'm not a normal person.
I'm a prophet of Allah.
I am a prophet of
Allah."
People were surprised. Oh, what is this baby are saying? Inni Abdullah, I am the servant of Allah, and Allah will give me the book, yeah? And Allah will make me a prophet, isn't it?
Yes.
That's why some people are thinking, Isa, he hasn't any dad. That's why people are thinking, Isa is the son of God. Is really, no. Isa is the son of God.
That's what Isa alayhi salam, new followers called him. But that's not right.
Sorry?
That's not right. That's what Isa alayhi salam, new followers called him. They called him the son of God, but the Quran rejects the son of God because Allah has no partners. He is the one and only God.
Allah has no
partner.
Allah does not have any son. Allah does not have any daughter. Allah does not have any
parents.
Dad and mom, mashallah. Then Rayyan, can you tell us about the teaching of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
Yes. There are many teachings of Isa alayhi salam in the Quran and the Bible. He taught his people to praise Allah and pay zakah and promote peace. He also taught his people to worship one Allah.
Mm.
Even in the Bible, it says that Jesus taught his followers to worship one God.
Mm.
The way that Isa alayhi salam taught was through stories.
Does mean Isa alayhi salatu wasalam does not have any dad, isn't it? He had already mom. Even Isa alayhi salatu wasalam teaching people to worship one God, isn't it?
Yes.
Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is not a God and not a God of son of God. God, isn't it?
Yes.
MashaAllah. Then can you tell us about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Maryam, Zainab?
The mission of Isa alayhi salam. In the Quran, it has said, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومصدقا لما بين يدي من التوراة ولأهل لكم بعد الذي حرم عليكم وجئتكم بآيات من ربكم فاتقوا الله وأطيعون. This means that Isa alayhi salam was sent as a prophet for the children of Israel to show them the right path and guide them righteousness. One of his missions was to confirm the Torah and to provide extra guidance to the children of Israel, which would be told in the Book of Injil, which is also known as the Bible. Jibreel al-Islam, who is an angel that sends revelation to the other messengers, helped Isa al-Islam by bringing the divine revelation to him.
Okay, mashallah. Basically, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam mission and other prophet mission was same.
Yeah.
All of the prophet of Allah used to call people to worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given the instruction in the previous scripture in the Torah, yeah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Isa alayhi salatu wasalam and given him the book, the Injil, yeah. Isn't it? The Injil is called Bible, cool.
Yeah.
Isn't it? And Ryan, what do you want to say about the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
I wanted to say about his unique abilities.
Yes.
Allah says in the Quran, وَيُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَحْلًا وَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Isa alayhi salam had many unique abilities.
Mm-hmm.
He was able to talk when he was in his cradle.
Mm-hmm.
When he had grey hair, he was able to cure the blind of his community.
Mm-hmm.
And he could create birds from clay and blow life into them.
Yes, and?
And I would also like to say about the ancestors of Isa alayhi salam.
No, another thing is unique quality. That's fantastic. You mentioned some unique qualities of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. It's called mu'jiza. Do you understand what is mu'jiza is? Mu'jiza is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given the prophet and messengers some special unique ability. Yeah, but it is given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was able to talk after his birth. One of the important things is because no one can talk like that after their birth, isn't it? Just yeah. After their birth. And those who was blind people, when the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam touched their eyes, they was able to see the world, isn't it?
Yeah.
And whatever you are eating at home, but bi-idhnillah, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam able to mention, oh, what did you eat at home, isn't it? Now Zainab, can you tell us about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam? Is the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam son of God? What do you think?
No. So the children of Israel rejected Isa alayhi salam as their prophet because they accused him of fraud.
Mm.
However, over the years, the Romans and the Greeks began to like Isa alayhi salam's teaching and they were translated into Greek and Latin. Isa alayhi salam had new followers, but they called him the son of God.
Astaghfirullah.
The son of God, that's not right because Allah has no partners. He has no siblings, no children, no parents. He is the one and only God.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Ikhlas, isn't it? قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ السَّمَدْ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. This Surah showed us and telling us and explaining us Allah is one and alone. Allah is one and alone. And Rayyan, what do you think about the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
The attempt to kill Isa.
Yeah.
Allah says in the Quran, وَقَوْلِهِمْ إِنَّا قَتَلْنَا الْمَسِيحَ إِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَا لَهُمْ وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِيهِ لَفِي شَكٍّ مِّنْ مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ إِلَّا أُتِّبَاءَ أُذُنْ وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَكِيمًا.
Yeah.
Indeed, we have killed the Messiah, Jesus, the son of Mary, the messenger of Allah, and they did not kill him, nor did they crucify him. But another was made to resemble him to them. And those who differ about it are in doubt about it. They have no knowledge of it except the following of assumption, and they did not kill him for certain. What this means is that they thought they killed Isa alayhi salam, but they did not. Allah had raised him to the heavens, and they killed someone that looked like him.
Interesting story, mashallah. Rayyan, you mentioned they wanted to kill Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Basically, whenever the prophet and messengers of Allah used to call people to worship to Allah and reject the idol, yeah, because idol is not a god, yeah, they don't have a right to give them worship, isn't it? And when the prophet and messengers given this da'wah, yeah, leave the idols, yeah, and worship to Allah, then people was angry with the Prophet and messengers. Like that, they wanted to kill Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Yes. And they think they killed Isa, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him
to the heavens.
In the heaven. Yeah. And he's still alive. We Muslims strongly believe that before the resurrection day, Allah will send him in this world, isn't it?
Yes.
And Zainab, what do you think about Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
I wanted to tell you about the followers of Isa alayhi salam before he had new followers that called him Son of God.
Yeah.
Isa alayhi salam had very few followers. They called him Isa alayhi salam's followers were called the Hawariyun.
Yeah.
All prophets faced extreme difficulties, but they never gave up the truth, because the truth always wins. If no matter what, whenever you're facing a problem, always tell the truth, and inshallah, Allah will help you.
Okay. Rayyan, what is the position of Isa in Islam?
Well, the position of Isa alayhi salam in Islam is very high. Muslims respect him and his mother.
Yeah.
We consider him a true prophet.
Yeah.
Allah mentions Isa alayhi salam in the Quran as the Masih, or the blessed one.
Like, we are Muslims. لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله. We believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. آمنتُ بالله. We believe in Allah. وملائكته, we believe in angels, isn't it? وكتبه, and we believe in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وكتبه ورسله, and we must believe all of the prophet and messengers of Allah, isn't it? Like Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet. Dawud alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet. That means whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent in this world before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of the prophet and messengers came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah? And we strongly believe that there was the prophet of Allah. We believe Isa was a prophet. Isa was a
prophet
and messengers of Allah. He was not a son of
God.
God, because Allah does not have any son and daughter. Yeah? We are human being. Allah is not human being. Do you understand it? We are human being, but Allah is not human being. Zainab, can you tell us? What do you think about
Islam? In Islam, Isa alayhi salam is a very high prophet, like all the other prophets.
Mm-hmm.
He has very high expectations, mm-hmm. and so like all the other prophets, Allah gives him miracles, and mm-hmm. he can do very things that we can't do, and yeah.
What was the miracle of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
He could, like Rayan said, he could cure the blind. Mm. He could, when he had grey hair, he could talk from his cradle when he was a baby.
Mm.
Yeah, and many other things.
Many other things. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to give the prophet and messenger this kind of miracle?
Allah used to give the prophets and the messengers miracles because so the people of the land where they are trying to give da'wah to believe them, that they are actually the messenger and the prophet of Allah. They could not actually perform the miracle without Allah's help.
Mm-hmm.
And that's...
That means Allah has given the miracle, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it is the special ability of the prophet and messengers, yeah? Because the prophet and messenger was not like a normal person and not like us, isn't it?
They were patient.
They was the real, real servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, isn't it? And if something does not provide for the people, the extra one, miracle one, the people will make the bad comment, oh, he's the messenger of Allah, how can we believe that? By the miracle, people can understand easily they are not the normal person, really, really, they are the special person from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a prophet, as a messenger. Yes, Ayan, can you tell us, what do you think about the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
I think Isa alayhi salam was a great person.
Yeah.
And if Allah had sent down angels instead of normal human beings, the people of the land would be like, oh, they're angels, we can't do that, they have more power than us. So Allah sent down human beings with special powers, miracles, and unique abilities that they could do. Without Allah's help, they can't do it.
Yeah. And another importance, aqidah, as a Muslims, do you think that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is going to come in this world again?
Yes, the last day.
The before the Qiyamah. Is he going to come as a messenger of Allah or as a follower of the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam?
Followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
As a followers of
Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Really, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was a prophet and messenger of Allah. But we have to believe that the Muhammad is the last prophet. Okay. Muhammad is the
last
prophet of Allah, last messenger of Allah. After Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no prophet and messengers coming in this world, isn't it?
Yes.
When the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will return in this world, come again in this world, then he will not come as a prophet and as a messengers. He will come as a followers of Muhammad. Then he will establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will call to the people to worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will establish the deen of the Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zainab, do you want to say the last word about the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam?
I want to say that in this life we should follow all, not only about Isa alayhi salam, Muhammad alayhi salam, all the prophets had different miracles, and that we should follow them. We should not just be our own person, and we shouldn't, like some days we might follow them and the others we don't. We must continue that in our life till the last day.
What do you want to say the last word about the Isa?
Expanding on what Zainab said, is that you can't just follow one prophet and not the other ones, then you won't be a true Muslim, because to be a true Muslim, you need to have the five pillars of Islam, and you need to believe in every single prophet, not just only Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and or Isa alayhi salam.
Another things is just I want to mention about that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, inna mathala Isa inda Allahi ka mathali Adam. Isa alayhi salatu wa salam example is like Isa, like Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. Adam does not have any dad and mom. Allah is able to create Adam without any dad and without any mom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala able to create Isa alayhi salatu wa salam without any
father.
Dad. Thank you very much. Dear viewers, thank you very much to watch our program Touching Minds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding about the Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us ability to follow the prophet and messengers. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.